It's the Sidwell Friends Quakers out of Washington, D.C., battling Calvary Christian out of Fort Lauderdale.
It's nothing like beating the game.
Taken away by Sharon Font. At the post, Ernie. Oh, Hendricks right back up. Oh, look out below. They dominate the second, and they go on and run away with this one by 22-59.
The Wilson Tigers thought they'd come into this game and win by 25. So did 90% of the public.
Let's go. This OC. This OC.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
You can't stop us. Yeah.
It was a good job. I'm Dylan Davis.
Hi, I'm Arinda Dashifusi.
My name is Coach Keegan.
I'm Charlie Taylor.
I'm Galen Cabway.
I'm Seldon Pickens. And I play basketball for Sidwell Friends School.
And I play for Sidwell Friends School.
Shooting guard at Sidwell Friends.
Point guard for Sidwell Friends.
Forward for Sidwell Friends.
Looking at like the polls on Instagram and stuff, we're always like, no one expected us to win semis or state finals. People just looked at us as like a Quaker school, an academic school. When really we're one of the best basketball teams in the country too.
They do not foul! And on Masters Saturday, hello Sidwell Friends, the champs of the SCI!
Yeah, they're definitely, after last year's season, there was a lot of, I wouldn't say necessarily hype, but like a lot of like expectations as far as like how we were ranked. Coming in ranked 10th in the nation.
D.C. zone Sidwell Friends. The Quakers were a preseason top 10 team in the nation.
That also was probably kind of like weighing on them to perform and to win every game.
Straight from the jump, I mean, it was just kind of back and forth. We get a lid, they get a lid, we hit a three, they hit a three. We were up by like two at halftime. But yeah, and then during halftime or halftime talk, we had to like really step things up, and we came out with the third quarter, got like a 14-point lead, playing extremely hard, doing things really good, and then it kind of went downhill from there.
Caleb Gillis, the younger brother, nice kick out to Chris Russell. Great pass, offensive foul on Chris Russell. Let's see if they can get a bucket here and really put some pressure on that Sidwell operation.
Fourth quarter, I fouled out. We had like turnovers, and then they started scoring a lot, and we kind of lost touch in our defense, and then essentially we blew away the 14-point lead, and they ended up winning the game.
Scout, beautiful swing, and the three. Oh my goodness! He is feeling it! Yes, that will do it, folks. Roman Catholic with a final score of 51 for Roman Catholic and 46 for Sidwell Friends. A stormy comeback from the KO Whites to finish that game.
As we get ready to bring to you the King Cotton Holiday Classic, Sam, we got a big time matchup here between Sidwell Friends, Quakers of Washington, D.C., and the Timberwolves of Beaumont High. I'm ready to get it on.
That was probably the worst game I've ever been a part of. It was pretty embarrassing.
This one's going to get out of hand if Sidwell can't get some baskets to fall. He's running in transition. Oh, behind the back dribble all the way to the cup. Oh, reverse layup, lays it up and in at the buzzer.
I'm in shock. Sidwell managed one field goal the entire first half. They're averaging half a made bucket per quarter.
We were like 1-for-20 in the first half, had like 4 points. It was a rough day. Nobody was able to hit a shot. And then fast forward into the fourth quarter, you have like 16 points. They have 40. We're getting like 30 ball. But really, that's something we just look to forget or look to, like, let's just say this never happened.
And 49-20, Beaumont all over Sidwell Friends here in King Cotton Holiday Classic.
We knew it was going to be a tough contest. We knew the type of talent and the great coaching staff they have over there in St. Andrews. It was on the road, one of those first early conference tests, coming off of some early losses that we talked about and wanted to kind of maintain our supremacy in the conference. So got off to a good start. I thought we played pretty well. So did they. It was kind of nip and tuck, back and forth. And it was just a situation where, you know, they made a few more plays than we did. We ended up fouling them on a buzzer-beating shot. The kid made a free throw. Kids and watch them celebrate the way that they did and kind of get the sting of that feeling. I didn't want to run off the court and not feel what it wasn't like to take care of your business, especially on the road. So that was definitely a tough moment for us as a team, but I think we learned from it.
All right, I'll go with my last of the day. Just trying to knock it out, finish the day off strong. Class right now. Waiting for our teacher to get here. Just get ready to learn. That's what it's all about. We come here early just to get some work in before the class time really starts, just to make sure we're nice and prepared for what we got going on. Oh, that's what it's about.
Number one is about a hotel that tried to hide people.
Would that help with my paper?
It would help with extra credit. It won't help your paper. I mean, it would not help.
Can I get information from there? What do you think?
No, it's a fixed. It's up there. The book might be real.
It's fixed.
The movie is definitely fixed.
I've had Redmark too.
Let's go.
Now you can do all the hanging and stuff, but you can only do that for the actual annotations.
Oh, we're not doing that for,
for the actual bibliographic.
Like, this is a lot. I'm gonna be honest.
But it also had directions, five directions.
What are you talking about?
That one through emotions.
What are you talking about?
Past benchmark three.
But you just finished benchmark two a day ago.
You haven't finished it either.
It's like half.
Hey, what's his say? Incomplete, right?
Academics has said, well, definitely like, makes me mentally tougher, just being able to handle like on the court stuff and like in the classroom and having an equal balance, knowing like when to do work, when to like get in the gym. Like, it really does make me a better person overall. I feel like this will make me a better person when I get out of Sidwell.
Nah, all class should be hard, but if you don't take your class in serious, but you're not going to one, like, all right, cut the camera. All
right. Yeah.
Watching Instagram lives talking about what Wilson's planning on doing to Sidwell, about how they're coming this year, it's their get back game and whatnot, and you can really feel the energies live all throughout Tinley Town.
Oh man, it doesn't get any better than that. Their crowd showed up tremendously. Like, you can feel the palpitation just in warm-ups, even before the game, during the JV game, the gym started to fill up, and you just knew it was going to be a raucous crowd. Told the guys that, you know, this is what you play for, this is what you want. You want these kind of environments to test us early in the season, to be able to get a feel for what it's going to be like, you know, during playoff time. So
I know God breathed on this. I know God breathed on this. I know God breathed on this. I know God breathed on this.
Tigers really controlled the lead for most of that first half, or completely that first half, to hide the lead up to 12. Quakers have got to control that pace a little bit more if they want to get back in this one.
Wide open for three, and he knocks that down.
Momentum has completely shifted. All the energy is with the Quakers here.
Achilles will work inside. Finds it.
Fury, and that's knocked down.
Huge shot there. 2-point game now.
Gotta be able to not turn the ball over and gotta be able to knock down their free throws. Just like I said, that they're gonna turn it over.
Rogan Roer working to the lane. And a tie ball game now. A tie ball game. Timeout from Sidwell. And this looks like a repeat of last year's state championship game. I'll tell you what. Working with five on the shot clock. Step back three-pointer. You betcha. Huge shot from Akaden Lewis. Back the other way come the Tigers. Here comes Dockery. Dockery working on Rogan Roer. Dockery will work inside. A three-pointer wide open for Primitz. Knocks it down! Bang! You betcha! Marvin Primitz knocks it down! Gilius working now. Gilius, 7 seconds left and a timeout from Singletary. What a play drawn up from Coach D. Johnson. Oh my goodness!
Can't give up a shot. One of the forces to get it in deep.
5.6 seconds left. Gilius will work. Tie ball game. Gilius to his left. A floater way off the mark as time expires. We will head to overtime. 47 seconds left. I'm Lee moving alongside Nathaniel Wigman. All we've asked for today in this game, Gilius working now as the shot clock expires to Arinze, and he knocks it down. Huge shot there. Nine on the shot clock left. Gilius inside of Williams. Williams slams it home. 3-point lead for the Quakers here.
Had to be one of the, like, the best nights just because we capped off like a perfect or almost perfect back season by getting back with the team that we lost to St. Andrews by a good margin, sending the seniors off like their last game on the home court.
The game meant a lot to us. Five seniors, we all started. We got to go out there and try to get back at St. Andrews, which we did. And, you know, just our crowd showing out, the atmosphere that we had, made it really easy to just go out there, execute, and play.
Shot City. And what I love most, she had so much soul. She said, excuse me, little homie, I know you don't know me, but my name is Wendy and I like to blow trees. And from that point, I never blow her off. Come from out of town, I like to show her off. They like to act tough, she like to tone them off and make them straighten up their hat, cause she know they soft. And when I grew up, she showed me how to go downtown. In the nighttime, my face face lit up. So astounding, I told her in my heart is where she always be. She never mess with entertainers cause they always leave. She said it felt like they walked and drove on me. Knew I was gang affiliated, got on TV and told on me. I guess it's why last winter she got so cold on me. She said, yeah, keep making that platinum and gold. Maybe we could start again. But if you really cared for her, then you wouldn't have never hit the airport to follow your dreams. Sometimes I still talk to her, but when I talk to her, it always seems like she's talking about me. She said you left your kids, and they just like you. They want to rap and make soul beats just like you.
The singers, I would like to talk about these singers as a whole. I told these guys in the locker room, one of the things that I was most impressed with was that this is the group that had to come through COVID, right? Including you guys, right? So it's always impressive to see the dedication, the commitment, all the things that it takes, you know, to be mentally strong enough to make it through that COVID period. This group has won a ton of games. They've given us all their spirit, all their love every time out. So I'm so proud of this group as a whole.
Ladies and gentlemen, we got a big game tomorrow night. Sidwell versus the number one seed. Top five team in the country. The number one team in the area, the guys from PVI. Can Sidwell pull off the upset? I don't think so.
You can't stop us!
We undefeated with this man.
Going into the PVI game, we obviously saw a lot of the noise people were saying, how we were going to get blown out. The game wasn't really going to be close. But for us, it was just about staying level-headed, focusing on ourselves rather than the other team. And that's what we did and went out there and shocked many people. But to us, it really wasn't a shock. We knew what we were capable of doing the whole time.
Remember, my man Jaquan went for the ball. I ripped it, shot a three lead into a timeout. That's when like the whole momentum of the game just shifted on our side, like even more. I got a dunk. My shoe ended up coming off, sliding around the court. Still hustled back on defense. Fell, but we ended up getting a steal and a layup after that.
They talking
Sidwell every day.
Food, boy. 680,000.
That's food.
Coming for y'all.
Hey, number one in the country. Number one.
Going into the postseason, it's really like do or die. Like one loss and you're out.
The series was tied for all the marbles. You know, everything was laid out on the table, and the winner got it all.
Sidwell is not even supposed to be here. They're supposed to be the high academic kids. What are they doing in here playing basketball at high level?
I don't see a scenario where Sidwell win this game.
I got a good, tough win against Theodore Roosevelt.
Yeah!
And then we're right back at it to play against Gonzaga, another really good team from the area.
Scoring my 1,000 point meant a lot to me, you know. It really just showed all the hard work I put in over my 4 years, and doing it in the state semifinal also meant a lot to me. As well as joining a great club with a lot of Sidwell legends definitely meant a lot to me as well.
Come on.
just had to prove people wrong. There's still some doubters.
I feel great, man. We played our heart out. I didn't want to go. I didn't want it to be our last game for the seniors, so we all played our heart out and got a good win. This is Arenze, and you're watching.
Yeah, Riz.
And you're watching Mango filmed it. Hoop session. All right, wait, what am I saying?
You know, we got there last year and won it, and all the guys that were there know the feeling and, you know, are hungry for that feeling again. So being this close, like, it just means that much more.
DCS AA Classic AA Championships. Sidwell Friends versus the Jackson Reed Tigers. What is now arguably the most intense rivalry in DC basketball. The atmosphere, the energy is palpable. Your thoughts on the feeling and the energy thus far?
I mean, bottle up the energy that is in this building right now. You can probably power DC for the next 100 years right now. This is incredible right here. I don't know if CW got this much energy during their games at home this season. It is an amazing atmosphere here tonight.
I can bet you that this is the most fans in the Smith Center probably in the last 5 years.
Already know who it is. It's your man AJ, the host, and we got big time basketball tonight. Yes, sir. The guys from Sidwell against the guys from Wilson. Wait a minute. The state finals? You got Sidwell? They're not even supposed to be in the championship. Those are the kids with the academics, high academic kids. They're not supposed to be in the championship of the hoops tonight, but they are. And they're going against the top guys from Wilson. Let's see how it goes. Jackson Reed, Sidwell. Let's see how it goes.
AA champion.
I'm undefeated.
streets ain't beat me, the police neither. I ain't got no sympathy for nobody.
I said that. Three times.
Hey, y'all had JR. Y'all had the money on JR. Sidwell, they had everything to prove in this one right here. They wanted to prove that they truly were one of the best teams in the DMV right here with this one. I don't think that there's any doubt about that now after tonight.
You don't get into coaching for getting pats on the back, right? As long as you guys respect me and like what I'm doing and you cherish the fact that we're all working with you to try to help you become the best you can be, that's the only thing that matters to me. All the other stuff is extra. Like, we got great parent support, great community support, but like that is irrelevant. What happens in this locker room means the world to me. So I couldn't be more proud of you guys. Seriously, like, I didn't have a chance to do this when I was a kid because it was just a public school and the Catholic League to play for this title. So I'm so appreciative that the state formed itself to make sure that schools like us who are on the rise can compete for this. It's surreal to me. Every time we enter the tournament and then we get to this stage right here for the championship game, it always makes me think back to Sidwell friends.
Oh God! I've been telling people we're gonna Sidwell. They'd be like, "What the f- Sidwell?
Sidwell, their friends, right? I've heard it all.
Midwell.
Seriously, guys, like, enjoy. I don't know what's next for our state invitational, all that other stuff. But we, just like last year, that was just extra basketball. Right now, I want you guys to enjoy this because you worked your tails off from that last calendar year to now. You worked your tails off, and I want you guys. And they're waiting at the finish line.
Oh, you're vlogging?
Hey, man, we vlogging, man. Back to the vlog, man. Hey, shout out to
my baby, no. My baby, go. I go.
Stay chance. Hey, man. I'm here with another vlog, man. We just vlogging, you know. Hey, you know, we got the parade out, you know. Talk to the vlog.
Ain't much to say, but, yeah, man.
Hey, say something to the vlog. Say something to the vlog, hey, Lou.
What would happen if different high school teams from across the country that won their state championship came together for one tournament? Well, that is exactly what's happening this weekend at the State Champions Invitational for both boys and girls hoops. For the boys, state champions from Georgia, DC, New Jersey, Utah, Washington, and Mississippi will be competing. There is going to be a ton of big names in this tournament.
Welcome to the State Champions Invitational, presented by Geico. Here at McDonough Arena, gorgeous Washington, D.C.
Bill Friends, Quakers. Nice pass inside that left hand from underneath the rim.
You can see Williams 5-1, just noticeably stronger.
Fusi gets that one to go, 4-0 early lead.
Tough man-to-man defense.
Three ball, Cam Gillis. Buries that one.
Gets the corner. Up under there. 8-24. On the time.
Two on one. The pan is in. That's a good fast break there.
At the end, the winner's number.
Hey, Matt, when you move the ball, the scoreboard changes when the ball sticks.
Yeah.
the handoff. Williams, the flush.
Hey, Sidwell friends, now this scrap.
Sidwell friends, here we are, the Wildcats and Sidwell friends Quakers here on Masters Saturday.
Does history actually repeat itself? In last year's State Champions Invitational, Sidwell friends lost in the semifinals to Calvary Christian. They move on to the championship to face off against Wheeler High School.
Kick out. That three is good. Just the man we talked about, Caleb Williams. Williams again. Left-hander, top of the three-point line, back-to-back.
You're gonna make your play for another 20 seconds, maybe. Maybe not.
Gillis says, I'll take it now. Two lead here for Sidwell friends. School just 3 miles north of the campus here. And how about going north, going up? It's Caleb Williams. Players in the junior class hanging out with us for a few minutes. Caleb Williams, left hand.
They gotta get his hand up on him.
That's his third three.
Lights are bright.
Woo! Caleb Williams! Hey, turnover number 20. Cam Gillis kick out. Oh, bring the house down. Looking inbound, 11 seconds to go. Achifusi dribbling, foul, 9 seconds to go, and now we've got a one. Achifusi, his first free throw attempts of the day. Hopefully, it's more than one if you're Sidwell friends. 1-1.
Need a three. And you have one timeout if you need it.
It's a three-point game, and it's time to go. Wheeler down three. DJ Mitchell inbounding. Here's Page. Page kicks to Hamilton and a foul. Hamilton in line with a 1-1. Gotta hit this one. Off the heel, rebound, Sidwell friends. They do not foul. And on Masters Saturday, hello, Sidwell friends, the champs of the SCI.
Thank you.
Oh my God. Sidwell is not even supposed to be here. They're supposed to be the high academic kids. What are they doing in here playing basketball at a high level?
I can't believe it. Not only, you said it, we said it. 2 years in a row, state champs. But then y'all went and took the state champion invitational. Oh my God, I was watching. And you got MVP. I'm so proud. You deserve it. You've been working so hard. I'm just so happy and proud, and I'm just excited that everyone gets to see, you get the recognition that you deserve. I'm so excited. Your team is the bomb. I love y'all.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yeah.
Can we get much higher?
So high.
Whatever your idea of what we have to go through at school, multiply that by two.
By two?
One word to describe the season?
You better get nothing.
What did you say? He's talking about.
All right, bro.
Coming to the season, I think there was some. I think there was some expectations. I still felt like we're.
All right. Did you think we were gonna be PBI?
Nah.
This is what we call. And we all say it. Serendipity. All right.
This for the doc self.
I mean, good out here.
This is what we call.
Serendipity.
Hey, Jay, get in the note.